from here, stomach four, turn the head. Now my thumb is on Triforma 17. And by doing this, I can apply that pressure in and drive them back again. So it's a continuation. I can use it as a standalone point, or I can use it in combination. So from here, yep, I've wrapped down a turn. I've got my palm into here, got my thumb into here now. Now I can drive him back, all right? And I've locked on here so that I've got some degree of control, because if I didn't lock on here and I push back, Dave disengages and we're in a fight, all right? So I need to be able to know what that person is doing. So again, from here, in, this time, edge of the hand on the fulcrum, going in vessel 26, up, turn the head, thumb on triple warmer 17 again. Yep. Now, once I've locked onto here, I've grabbed on, or I've control, I've pinned to the body. If I apply pressure into here and start to turn here, yep, you can see how it affects the person and turns and brings them down. Now, again, I can do lots of different things with this. Just depends where I want to go with it. I could release and drop the fist straight onto the stomach five. Okay, or large intestine 18. But do you see what I mean from here? It's all about that control. One, two, turn, triple warmer 17. This time, rather than just pin it here, I'm going to actually grab the wrist so that as I push into here and start to turn my body, I can start to lock into these points. We'll talk about the points on the wrist later on, and the hands. All right. And now, as if he went down, I've got control of his arm to go for arm breaks and all sorts of stuff. It's just an example. There's a multitude of ways you can use these techniques. Again, you know, it could be that Dave's holding on to a third party. He's clinging on, and I want to control the neck again because he's got this fight in him. He's gripped hold of somebody. Into here again, I go into one side or the other. Okay, I could go to both sides and apply the pressure in. Yeah. Now from here, it releases the neck, so I can control the neck. All right. But also by going to triple warmer 17, I can lift up, and then I can rapidly drop it back down. So it's a two-way thing. So Dave's grabbing onto the person. His focus is here. In, into the points, you're releasing the neck, up and down, and take him down and finish it. Yep. But what it does do, sorry, all right, and that's horrible, isn't it? Okay, what it does do is applying pressure into here, it releases that neck. So if Dave was grabbing onto to whoever, okay, and Dave's the aggressor, by me coming in over to the top of the shoulder, into here, almost like I'm gripping in with the index finger and middle finger, into here just to make sure that I get it, press in, it releases the head. Now you can see I can peel him back. It's released that neck. Now again, from here, I could stomp to the back of the leg on some of the points that we're going to talk about later, okay, and take the person down. So it's a really useful point. And again, remember, we're talking about using them in combination. So we're using it in combination to control a person's head, control a person's body movement. If you control the head and you control their direction of their face, you control the person's movements, okay? And that's important because by doing that, but like I say, in whichever instance, you know, Dave's latch onto somebody, I go into here, I control this head movement here. See, his arms want to come back because Dave instinctively wants to try and grab my hands, all right? Now, an interesting thing I want to just add to this as well, and this can be done on any of the points, okay? It can be done on stomach four, stomach five, governing vessel 26, triple warmer 17. We're just at the moment applying constant pressure, right? Now, for want of a better explanation, if you imagine the needle that a tattooist would use, yeah? You know, those are the electronic ones, and it's literally lots of little tiny taps, isn't it, as the needle pierces. That's what we're going to do with our fingers. Because instead of having one strike, constant pain is going to have a multitude. Now, it's not that I'm going to go like this on his neck, because that'd be silly. But what it does is applying pressure and vibrate, little vibration. It's going to, imagine it's almost like a shiver. You're just shivering into the point. Yeah? So when you do this, the effect is far more dramatic.
Oh.
Okay?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah,
that's not nice. Okay, but you can see how effective it is. And it's just the same point, but vibrate into it. All right?